Welcome to Horizon. Hi, I'm Jan, a Shopify developer and educational partner. Today, our mission is to build an e-commerce store for a client in the coffee industry. The coffee market is one steeped in competition. So our client wants us to create a new feature that showcases the strength of their different coffee offerings. To achieve this, we'll use the Horizon theme and its powerful theme blocks. Theme blocks are transforming the way developers approach building websites, allowing us to create unique, customizable layouts without getting lost in the code. Theme blocks are equally beneficial to your clients. They provide a powerful option for showcasing their unique content and design preferences, offering the flexibility to make their website shine while keeping development time efficient. Now, let's dive into the website build. All right, so I hope you enjoyed this little intro, and this is going to be the website that we'll be working on today. As mentioned, it's an imaginary coffee brand, and we've set up the whole storefront using the Horizon theme. Now, up until this point, we can pretty much consider this a fresh copy of the Horizon theme, because so far we've only used pre-built elements in order to configure the homepage. So for example, this first section here is just a normal hero section where we uploaded a background image and adjusted the headline. The second is just a product list where we've selected our favorite collection. And the other two sections down below are built based on custom sections, which is just another section type that the theme provides out of the box. And here we've leveraged theme blocks like images, texts, or product cards to create this simple block layout or the coffee of the month section. Okay, now here's what we'll be developing throughout this video. We will create a brand new theme block type that showcases the strength for each of the coffee blends so that customers have an easier time choosing their own preferences. In order to achieve this, we need to solve a few sub-problems or challenges. For example, we need to find a place where we can store that value initially and then also read it from. Then we need to create the theme block itself and its logic. And we also want to make sure that the theme block can only be used in places where it makes sense. Like for example, here in context of a product, but it wouldn't make sense to have the strength indicator in the hero banner or in context of a blog article, for example. So these will be the things that we will take care of step by step. So then let us tackle the first challenge. Where do we store this additional information on a per product basis? Since we're trying to extend an existing data model, namely products, using a metafield would be a good choice. In order to create a new product metafield, let's head back to the admin dashboard and then click on products. Then we can bring up any of the coffee blends. On the product editor, let's scroll down until we reach the metafield definitions. And right now I don't have any metafields pinned nor defined, so I will go to view all definitions and create a new one for the coffee strength. Here we can just follow the user interface and add a new definition. Here I'll add a descriptive name, coffee strength for example, but the name doesn't even matter as much, because what really matters are the namespace and key, because this is how we later access this metafield. And right now this metafield is defined under the namespace custom, which is fine with me, and then .coffee underscore strength, so we have to keep that in mind. The metafield type can be integer, because we're just trying to store a value between 1 and 5. And if we want for extra safety, we can also validate this field, so the minimum value would be 1 and the maximum would be 5. Let's save this new metafield definition. And now the new metafield is created successfully and we can add data entries. So then, back on the product editor, we can go ahead and add some arbitrary test values. So the metafield definition is right here, and for the first one, I'll just add a strength of 5. And now I'll quickly pause the video right here and add some different values for all the other blends. Okay, so now we fast-forwarded this and added one metafield value for each of the coffee products. Okay, so now that we have a good place to store our metafield value, to store the coffee strength, now it's time to move on with creating the theme block. And I think the best way to go about it is to first create it and make sure that it shows up on the theme editor. And then we can take care of accessing the metafield in the same go before building the actual logic. From the admin dashboard, let's bring up Shopify's internal code editor. And since we're interested in creating a new theme block, let's head over to blocks, create a new file, and we can call this block coffee strength as well. Now to save a bit of time typing, I'll just get rid of everything in this file and then copy and paste the schema that we have prepared. If you like, you can also add a few line breaks for better overview. And right now, this schema is boiled down to the most essential attributes that we need. So every theme block needs a name. I'll just go with coffee strength here. Then we need an array of settings or input elements. And right now I only defined one of type product, so a product picker. The ID can also be product. We only need this to reference this product picker in our markup later on. And then also a basic label, select the product. And then we also have the presets down here, which are important because otherwise the block wouldn't show up on the theme editor. So here we have to provide the name that will be displayed on the theme editor. And if we want, we can also provide an initial configuration for the settings that we defined above, for example, pre-select a specific product. But for now, we don't need that. Now, this schema alone would already be enough to make our new theme block show up on the theme editor. But even if we added to a specific section, we wouldn't see anything because we haven't implemented anything yet and haven't defined any markup. So what I want to do next is define a new variable called strength. The way this works is that we first access the product that is specified in the block settings. So the product that's coming from this product selector here. Then I want to access all the meta fields of that product, but we're actually just interested in one very specific meta field, the meta field we just created that lives under the namespace custom.coffee_strength. And this is why the key and namespace were so important. And then after trying to read this new meta field value, I'll say if strength is not blank, so if we successfully retrieve the value, I'll just output this value right here. And this is not going to look fancy or anything. There's not even well-structured HTML. This is just the first test. If we're able to successfully add the theme block and if we're able to successfully read the meta field, and it helps us prototype and debug everything step by step. So then let's go ahead and save this new file. And after the next refresh on the theme editor, we should already find our new theme block. So I'll just click into the section where I want to make my changes. This unfolded the product list. Here we have the product card, and nested inside we find another group. So this contains the product title, the product price, and some swatches that we don't see right now because we don't have further product variants. And right on top of the product title, I now want to add a new block. And as a first item, we can already see our new block coffee strength. So let's go ahead and add this. And now we can see that our new block was added successfully, but we're not seeing anything on the front end yet. Most likely because we're not properly reading the meta field value yet. And that is because we haven't even selected a product in our product picker. Using this product picker, we have two options. We can either select a specific product, for example, the Brazilian coffee, but that wouldn't really help us because, okay, now we're seeing something on the front end and the meta field for the Brazilian coffee is accessed correctly. That's awesome. But now all the products show the same strength because they're all trying to access the meta field from the Brazilian coffee, which doesn't make much sense. So I'll go ahead and remove this product here. And then instead, I want to connect a dynamic data source. And this is new with theme blocks because we can now select a new dynamic data source, namely the closest product to this element. So here I'll go ahead and select closest product. And this will now pull the data from the closest product object, which is in this case, the product card that we're dealing with. And now we're also seeing the right meta field values for each of the coffee blends. Awesome. And now we can continue, improve the logic, and make sure that we're rendering the coffee beans instead of these hard-coded text values. Back in the code editor, the first thing we now want to add are the icons that we need, the coffee bean in its outlined and full color version. And a good place to add these is the assets folder of our theme, where we can also find of the icons that are shipped per default. And here I've uploaded two new files, the icon-coffee-bean-filled and icon-coffee-bean-outlined. And we will provide this for you as well. After uploading the icons, we can come back to our theme block file. And now we want to replace this hard-coded text right here with as many filled and outlined coffee beans as the strength tells us. In order to do this, I'll first add an outer container to wrap all the icons. And I've also added a CSS class of flex, which is already built into the horizon theme. So then the coffee beans will be stacked inline horizontally. And now we just have to come up with a smart way to render as many filled coffee beans and as many outlined coffee beans as contained in the strength variable. For example, if the strength is equal to 3, then we want 3 filled coffee beans and 2 outlined. One way to do this is by starting with a for loop that counts from 1 to 5, because we will always have 5 icons. And then as long as the index, the current index or iteration of the for loop, is less or equal to the strength, we want to put out a filled coffee bean. So I'll take one of these filled beans right here. And otherwise, if the for loop index or the current iteration is greater than the strength, then we only want to continue with outlined coffee beans. And then we can get rid of the rest. So one more time, first we try to access this metafield value, we try to read the coffee strength. If we find a value, we put out our container that's supposed to wrap all the icons and display them inline. And then we want to render 5 icons in total. As long as we're below the strength or equal to the strength, we put out the filled coffee beans. But if we're exceeding this limit, then we start to render outlined coffee beans for the rest of the iterations. And after the next refresh, we can now see the filled out or outlined coffee beans depending on the coffee's strength. And it looks a lot better than the hard-coded text values that we had before. Awesome. Now the last thing we wanted to accomplish in this video is limit our new theme block to positions where it makes sense, because displaying the coffee strength and also selecting the closest product as dynamic data source only makes sense inside a product card, for example, but not as much in the hero banner. And this is actually quite easy. We just need to come back to the code editor and find our theme block inside the blocks folder. I quickly search that right here. And then we have to rename this file and add an underscore at the beginning. And here you can see that this is also done for quite a few of the other theme blocks, because the underscore turns them into private theme blocks that can only be accessed in places where it's specifically defined. And now we can try to find our product card block and specifically allow the coffee strength as an available block type. So here I scroll down to product card. Right here. And in the schema of the product card, we can already see that this allows several different block types, all named specifically. So the product card is not accepting every global theme block, just the ones mentioned here. And in the same way, we can now add our own block type, underscore coffee strength, and then save this file. So now the product card should accept our own block type. And after one last refresh on the theme editor, we now have to re-add our theme block because it got removed from the group because we didn't specifically allow the strength indicator to be inside group blocks. We only allowed it to be in product cards. So right after the product media and on top of the group, I'll go ahead and add the coffee strength, select the dynamic data source, closest product. If we want to have this inside the group, we would have to specifically allow the coffee strength block type inside group blocks. But right now it's only available on product cards. And for example, if we go to the hero banner, we wouldn't be able to add this block type because it's private and not explicitly allowed on hero sections. All right, and that's it for this video. I really hope you enjoyed. And I also feel this was a great holistic example because it was based on a real-world freelancing scenario. We had to use a meta field. We learned how to create theme blocks from scratch, how to use dynamic data sources, such as the closest product, which is new. We had to write some liquid logic and also had a quick look at block scoping, which can be important. So I really hope you enjoyed this one. And also keep an eye open for our other episodes on Horizon and theme blocks, which are also awesome. It has been my absolute pleasure, and I wish you an amazing rest of your day. I'll catch you later. Bye.